Excuse me.
If it's possible, try not to go towards the stairs. Let's stay on this level.
Yeah, I don't know where.
So, welcome everyone. This is Social Dissonance, and I will have to inform you that we are being filmed, and the film is being streamed online. So, unfortunately, if you don't want to be filmed, we cannot do something to change that. I will ask you if you can stay for the whole concert. It helps a lot for a situation to be built inside the space. And for the concert to begin, I would very kindly ask you to stand up. And spread a bit inside the room. And let's try to move our bodies according to this body's movement. You can all leave your stuff wherever you want.
Thank you. Ha ha ha!
What are we doing?
Excuse me.
Do you feel nice doing that?
I feel nice doing that.
You feel happy?
We feel happy.
Everyone feels happy?
you could copy all the moves, but not the last move I did. I guess the biggest difference is today, I don't know what were people to follow all the moves until the Nazi salute. It seems you can copy everything but this. I'd like to understand what's the difference.
Ask some questions and to start talking. Some people still imitated her, and it didn't lead to the cutting off of the imitation and the starting of another thing like a conversation or something like that. But I think that what else was interesting is that they did not on. There were difficulties in imitating also other moves rather than, apart from the Hitler salute that you did in the end, such as getting our tops off, for example, except from Daphne and me, no other woman, really. What I found more interesting was that also there was a problem in imitating like big gestures, big sentimental conditions such as laughing or crying in a big way. How can I? Yeah. And yeah, actually, this is very, very interesting to me that we can be here and do anything, imitate every move like this or that, or moves that we do in our everyday life, and they are up to a certain limit of normality, yeah. But when something is bigger than we tend to do, sentimentally and physically, and I don't know, we cannot do it.
That some people actually did it, dance. I saw for people can you say who said I do like that? Don't want to expose now. I saw before that there were four people that they could do it actually. Or they didn't understand what happened. You, but you're told, but who else?
Yeah,
I'm sure. Yeah. In the middle of experiment, you
So I think it was very interesting the way it escalated today, especially when I tried to break the situation and make people realize what was happening. The fact that this initial proposal got so carried away, like, let's imitate this body, and it kind of, from this, it kind of went to let's take off our clothes or let's spit on each other. I think at some point it was quite violent. And I found really interesting also the fact that when the clothing was coming off, there were only two women, and both of them were performers, and there were five men who did it.
Because for me it wasn't like imitation all the time, it was like reaction. So I decided if I wanted to imitate or if I wanted to join the group or if I wanted to decide against it. Because, yes, I think no one gave us the order to imitate. Sometimes it's great to have a group feeling, but when it was too much, when it was like, but not any sense in it for me, like the imitation or where my reaction was this and not imitating it. I think it was also very interesting that at the beginning it was like, oh, it's cool that we are building a group, but then later it was always a decision for me personally, also that if everyone was starting to think of throwing the clothes away, I started to move in a totally different way against the group because I didn't want to join that. So maybe it's also a point to think about it. It's also been a reaction.
Yes, but the question is why some things make sense and some things don't. I mean, why does it make sense to you to do this and not to do or get your top off?
Because you've got to feel it, don't you?
You can. Mm-hmm.
You've got to feel that. You don't need to feel anything doing this, basically. It's just like well, when you actually get out to get involved, as you said, sentimental in some ways, you've got to feel it. Basically, you do only the things that you feel like doing. That's it.
I think for me, some aspects were a bit something like sport. So it was more like okay, you can follow like following some sports, and then other aspects was more like this that there's something small going on and to figure out if there is a direction or not. And then when the big gestures were offered, the smaller ones weren't present anymore. So I think this part was disturbing somehow, that there can be something else. And also, and I was thinking, it's about a composition within the space, and as far as I understood, and it's not the composition just following, it could be a multi-layer situation, and while strong gestures are given, it's decision to follow or not, but the others were very, have very little space. This
so
was a bit a pity.
And where exactly did it start? Where do your gestures turn into a composition? When do your gestures become art? Is it because we're here and we're not in the street? Is it because we're waiting to see Documenta? The fact that whatever we do, we call it art?
It's not okay, it's made.